Hey everybody, it's Liz. Welcome back to my channel. Today I have for you a couple more projects. Again, these are also unicorn themed as well as my, you know, previous videos. This is for the same swap. This is for my swap partner. And like I said, I wanted to break it down into several videos so that I wouldn't have one long video. So this project that I'm gonna share today is the main project, which we agreed would be a loaded embroidery hoop. It's my first time making one and they were actually a lot of fun. Although I did have a difficult time with stuffing it. I know some of you ladies just stuff it to the brim and I just had a really hard time with it. So anyways, enough of the chit chat. Let me move into the project. So here is my embroidery hoop and it is quite big as you can see. I believe this is either an 8 or a 9 inch. I don't remember exactly. So it turned out really cute. I actually really liked it. Like I said, the only really hard thing that I had, and then let me show you the back. Oops, everything's gonna fall. The only hard time that I had with it was stuffing it. I couldn't get everything to fit in there. I mean, I know I've watched some of you and you guys like stuff it so much. I'm like, oh my gosh, how do you get everything in there? But I had a really hard time with that. So I tried my best. So, okay, I guess what I'm gonna do is I am going to, and of course you can see, it's for Armine, so don't watch. If you're watching, shut it off right now. Okay, so anyway, I'm gonna, I guess, pull the things out and then kind of go over them, and then I'll go over, you know, the actual hoop itself. Okay, so I'm gonna start off with a couple of things. So this is just a little sticker pack that I picked up for her. Again, this is a unicorn theme, so a lot of the embellishments will be unicorn theme. This one, I think I picked it up at Hobby Lobby, and basically I just kind of repackaged it, or, you know, just kind of made it pretty. So I added some cardstock, a little piece of paper from the collection we're working on, which is the Prima Havana, in case you already don't know. And then this is just some little tassel trim, like a little piece that I added right here at the bottom. This is a little bow that I created using that faux leather from Hobby Lobby in gold. I added one of these little, what are these called? I can never think of the name of them. But I use it as the center for my bow and it looks like it's a little blurry. Let me see if I can focus a little bit. Sorry. Is that a little bit better? So I just used one of these, and these are one of the Seiden crystals from the Prima Havana collection that I added to the center of my bow. This is one of the ephemera pieces from the collection and it's really cute how I just, you know, repackaged it. And let's see, the next thing I made was this little bag here. This is the little glassine bag that I had in my stash. I embossed it using a floral embossing folder. I added a pretty little gold doily. This is a piece from the ephemera pack. I have a couple of fishtail banners tucked behind that. And then I have a little flower here from the Havana collection as well. And there's a tiny little mini clothespin behind that. I glued the flower to the clothespin, but you can take this off and then, you know, you reuse it if she would like, or, you know, just leave it on here. I made everything, like almost all the packaging, reusable so that, you know, she can take out whatever embellishment she needs and then reuse the packaging if she wants to. So, oh, my little doily got a little bent. So this little pocket is, let's see, I think I added die cuts. Yeah, I made some unicorn die cuts using my Cameo. And these are the die cuts right here, and they turned out really pretty. I used a lot of rose gold in them because that's what, you know, is in the paper collection. So I just thought it would go really well. And I think I have 3 of them in there, and they are ready to go for her. They are on, you know, heavier cardstock, so that she can definitely, you know, use these in other projects and stuff. So really cute. So I added that. And then I had picked up these flowers from Michaels and I thought the colors went well with the collection, minus the purple, but I thought, you know, it still kind of went with the whole color scheme. So for this one, I just kept it in the same packaging, but I did add, I cut this out and then used an edge punch here on the bottom. I think I did on both sides. Oh no, just the front. And just to create a decorative edge. And then this is like a little scallop circle die that I you know, cut out using a scrap of the paper. I made a rose gold crown, or punched it out. I think that's a Martha Stewart punch. And I punched it out maybe 3 or 4 times so that I could layer them and it could be a little bit dimensional. So really pretty with the rose gold. And then here's a ticket that I fussy cut from the collection, and then a cute little mini clothespin. So, and then I just fussy cut some of these letters from one of the papers and spelled out the word flowers. So really pretty. And again, she can like open this from the bottom and reuse the packaging. Okay. And let's see the other thing. I found these really pretty pearl beads, or not flatback pearls. I think I got these at Dollar Tree, and I thought the color went really well, again, with the whole you know, color scheme of the embroidery hoop. I did the same thing. I just cut out one of the pattern papers and then edged it, or punched this edge here at the bottom. I spelled out pearls, and this one I used the same scallop circle die, but this time I did the unicorn bust, and this is a Spellbinders die that I just cut right here at the bust. Again, I layered maybe three or four different die cuts to give them a little more dimension. I have a little ticket that I fussy cut from the collection. Here is a little piece of crepe paper that I pleated and then added a little crochet trim to the middle. And all of this is just on here with a little mini clothespin that, again, she can reuse the clothespin, reuse all these little pieces, because nothing is adhered to the packaging. So, you know, that way she can, you know, use them again if she likes. And again, just open it from the bottom, take out your embellishments, and you can reuse the packaging. And let's see what else. I also made this little mason jar filled with sequins, and I was inspired by Rosa. Rosa's Creative Way, I believe, is her channel. I'll put the link down below, but she had made some embellishments a while back using her mason jar and a couple of other little things, and I thought that was a really cute idea. So I did this using my fuse tool and some plastic sheets that I had, the paper protectors or whatever. And I die cut the mason jar out of the Prima paper, added it to the inside, you know, pocket once I used my fuse tool to fuse it together. And then of course added a bunch of sequins in there. There were some stars, some regular sequins. And then I punched out a little bit of these circles. These are the Party City, oh my gosh, what were they called? Those little die cuts. And I just punched out little circles using the unicorn faces. So it's really pretty. And then I topped it off with another faux leather bow. And I used one of the Satin crystals in the center. So it turned out really cute. I love it. And see, it's backed with that really pretty paper with the rose gold. So it's a really cute little shaker mason jar. And then I had it put this little paper clip on top, but I had shared these before in my video, one of my previous videos. These are the little die cuts from Party City, and I just created paper clips out of them. I have one on each side just to hold the paper clip in the middle. The paper clips are rose gold, and they're from Michaels. And so for this, I just, you know, added the little flowers and then a cute little glittered star. It turned out really cute. So just a little paper clip that she can, you know, reuse in a planner or on a project. And then I made her these really pretty roses. These are using that Altenew rose dye that we are all in love with. And I created them using the Prima Havana paper and rose gold foiled paper from Hobby Lobby. And they turned out so beautiful. I just love the way they look with the rose gold. And then the leaves are just, you know, cut using that same dye and two shades of green cardstock. And then I have a little tiny bit of a glue dot and behind each of the flowers so that they can stay put. I backed it with some Prima paper from the Havana collection, and then my packaging again has the same style as the other ones. It's just a strip of the paper. I, you know, used that decorative edge punch. I added little pearls here on top, just these little flatback pearls. I fussy cut these flowers from the collection, added some pink crepe paper that had the little crochet trim, and then this was also fussy cut from the collection and just says a grateful heart. And I have that popped up on some foam to give it a little more dimension. The flowers are inked. I did ink around the edges so that it could stand out more. And I just love the way that this one turned out. I think it's so pretty. So, you know, this is the back. Look how beautiful this paper is. This one was just gorgeous, but it was so busy. So that's why I kept it on the back and used this more, you know, subtle pattern instead to showcase the flowers. And they turned out so beautiful. I hope she loves them. And then I just added one of these little stirrers. I think I picked these up at Target. I like them because they have a little diamond. So I'm always thinking diamonds, you know, things that are shiny and stuff like that go with the whole unicorn theme. So I just tucked that one in there in the back. And then I also made her this little cute chip bag. And I thought this was so adorable. I will share the link down below where I found the tutorial. I cannot remember her channel's name, but I think her name is Myra. And it's either My Lovely Designs or something like that. I can't remember. But I will put the link down below so that you guys can take a look, because I did follow her tutorial. to create this cute little bag of chips. They're very similar to, you know, the pebbles that we were all finding like a Tuesday morning that have the little die cuts. So that's kind of what I was going for. It turned out really, really cute. I just followed the tutorial step by step. And then of course, you know, it kind of just changed a couple things. I think she used die cuts to spell out the words, but I didn't have any letter die cuts, so I just used some thickers from my stash that I thought would go well with the collection. And I actually kind of like these because they are, you know, they have more dimension to them, and then of course they're glittered, so I just thought they went really well. And even though this is a unicorn theme, I did want to create a few embellishments that she can use after we're done with our swap. Like, she could definitely, you know, use them on other types of projects. And I know the Havana collection has a lot of birds, so I made her some bird die cuts, and they turned out so cute. So basically, let me see, you just open this up, and there's several in there. I'm only gonna take out one or two so you guys can see them. But these are made using the Tim Holtz caged bird die. And it really just turned out so cute. It comes with, you know, that cage, large cage, and then the cute little bird. And it's a couple pieces, so I paper pieced the bird itself, the body of the bird, and then of course had to do the little branch in rose gold. The wing is, you know, cut using a different piece of paper, and it just turned out really, really cute. I backed it onto some heavy duty cardstock so that they could be nice and sturdy for her. All she needs to use is maybe some foam tape or some pop dots and add it to her projects. So I just really love the way that these turned out. I think they're super sweet. And again, I didn't want to make everything or have everything unicorn, so that way she can definitely use these on other projects, other types of projects. So there are several birds in there, really cute. A lot of them have the rose gold accents. And then this is the back of the bag. Isn't it cute? Her tutorial also includes a free printable so that you can get the nutrition facts and the barcode. It's so cute. And the barcode down here, it says made with love. So I just thought it was a really, really cute idea to make this little chip bag and add, you know, a couple of die cuts in there. And like I said, I will share the link to the tutorial down below so you guys can take a look, okay? And I think that's it. That's all I was able to fit in there, even though I did make other embellishments. In fact, you know what? Let me share those, because I made a couple of other things, but I just couldn't fit them into the embroidery hoop. So I made this little sequin mix. And I love the way it turned out because it's super cute. I used a little white paper bag from my stash. Again, I used that rose embossing folder. I believe it's a Maggie Holmes embossing folder. And then so inside is my sequin mix in this cute little bag. But I just really wanted to decorate a little bit more. So then I used a pretty embroidery floss, and then just kind of looped it around to hold a little spoon in place, because I did want to include a spoon. These little wooden spoons you can find at Hobby Lobby in the party section. And what I did to mine, I did paint the handle in a baby pink, and I also stamped on it with a watermark ink pad, Versamark, and it just says magical. I'm not sure if you're gonna be able to see that, but I just wanted it to be subtle. And then here I have another one of those little satin crystals inside another one of these little buckle things. And I think it's called ribbon buckles, right? I don't know, but I just thought that looked really, really pretty. So that's a sequin mix. And like I said, I had made all these embellishments thinking I was gonna be able to fit them all in there, and I just could not get everything in there. So I'll probably package those separately for her. And then I also included this little sticker pack. I thought this one was really, really cute with the unicorns. They're kind of like funky little unicorns, especially that one, he's kind of fat. But I thought this was really cute, and hopefully she likes this one too. So basically this is just cardstock. I used an Ed Punch to create this little scallop edge. Used a piece of the patterned paper, and then I fussy cut some elements from the collection, and then I just adhered them on there. Some of them have pop dots or foam tape to give them dimension. And that's it. Really, really simple packaging, but I think it's really pretty just to, you know, repackage it and make it all go with the embroidery hoop. And then the last thing that I made for her was this. These rosettes are so beautiful. I love the way they turned out. And again, these, I did not make them unicorn themed because I want her to be able to use them in other projects. So these I used crepe paper in mint and pink, and they're double layered rosettes. So there's two rosettes. Hopefully you are able to see that. The one on top is glittered, with some chunky rose glitter that I had in my stash. They turned out really pretty. In the middle of each of them is a scallop circle that I cut out from the papers, another smaller circle in the center, and then I fussy cut some elements from the paper pack so that I can embellish the centers. And then hopefully, I don't know if you could see it, but in the background there's like a little bit of almost like string. I picked this up at Target. This was a while ago. Let me grab it so I can show you. It's called Rose Gold Cording. It's this right here. And it's kind of braided, so I kind of took it apart and then made like, see, it's like three little pieces. So I just kind of took it apart and then have it like tucked behind the little circles. Just, I don't know, I really like the way that that looked. Kind of like a messy look, but I think it turned out really pretty. And like I said, the little birds were fussy cut from the collection, and I have them on there with some foam tape. I have a piece of the pattern paper in the background, and then to top off my little bag, I created this beautiful, I love the way this one turned out, it's so pretty. So I just cut a piece of the pattern paper, adhered it to the bag, and then I used two layers of white lace. I love the edging on this lace, it's so pretty. It's almost like a ruffled look. And I just love the way that that turned out. And basically I did that to decorate it, because the paper behind is really, really busy. So I thought by adding the lace, it kind of softened it up a bit. I really love the way they turned out. And I think I'm gonna use this lace technique on other packaging because it's really pretty. This is one of the ephemera pieces. I added a little rose for my stash. This is another ephemera piece that I just folded over. So it's on the back as well. But see, this is the paper. See how busy it was? I just thought that was too much, you know what I mean? But when you add the lace, it's so pretty. It just softens the whole thing, and I love it. I absolutely love the way this packaging turned out. And I love the rosettes, and hopefully she loves them as well. But like I said, I just could not get them into the embroidery hoop, so it was just too much. So here's my embroidery hoop, you guys, and I love the way it turned out. It is so pretty, so sweet, and as you can see, it's quite big, so I can't get the whole thing in frame, but it's either an 8 or a 9 inch, I can't remember, but I didn't paint it. I wanted the raw wood edges, whatever is, you know, left that isn't covered, and I just, you know, backed it with some beautiful paper, and then, of course, there's paper on the back, and there's my little stamped handmade little stamp, and then the edges have this beautiful braided trim that I had in my stash. It's this gorgeous pink trim, beautiful color, and then I just covered all of the edges of the embroidery hoop with that. It just turned out really pretty, and of course I've seen it before, I've seen it done where you guys make unicorn out of this, and I just had to do one myself because it is a unicorn theme after all. So I made the horn using some felt, and I basically stuffed it with you know, that stuff that you use for like stuffed animals and things like that. I stuffed it with that, and then I wrapped that cording around it to create these the look of, you know, a more realistic horn, if you will. And then the ears are also felt. I cut them out of felt, and then the center part is cut out of glitter paper. But I do have them, I backed them with some heavier weight cardstock so that they would be nice and sturdy, and that they would, you know, stay upright. This part is kind of messy. I didn't like the way that that looked, but I figure, you know, she can hang it and you won't be able to see it. I thought about adding something there, but I just couldn't think of what, you know what I mean? But I think just this, just look at this. I mean, don't look at the back. So, and then let me see, oh my gosh, it's so pretty. Tons of flowers from the Prima Havana collection that I just, you know, glued on here, and they're so beautiful, different sizes. Some have glitter on them and some do not. I added these really pretty rose gold leaves throughout the little flowers. These are from a Maggie Holmes die. And then the eyelashes, I, you know, cut them out using my Cameo, just the perfect size for the face to make like a beautiful little unicorn face. And I think it turned out so pretty. I just love the way it looks. I made two pockets here, hoping to fit everything in there, but it didn't work out. But it still looks really cute, I think. So two pockets using the pattern paper, and then some heavier cardstock behind that with a decorative edge on each one. And it turned out so, so pretty. For down here at the bottom, I wanted it to be not really busy, so I knew I wanted to put her name on it. So I die cut these clouds using some pink paper, and then I have her name spelled out almost like it was sitting on top of the clouds. And these are some beautiful rose gold alpha stickers that I picked up from Michael's, and they went really perfectly with just everything. And then here I just, you know, topped it off with a beautiful mint crepe paper rosette. Again, I glittered the edges, added the scalloped circle. This time I added that cute little die cut from Party City with the little flowers. I put glitter on his horn and then a glittered heart. And it's just so beautiful. It is a double rosette, this one as well. It just turned out so pretty, you guys. I am so in love with this project. So I really, really hope she loves it as much as I loved making it. I just wish that I would be able to have everything in there, you know what I mean? I know some of you ladies make them with fabric, and I think that, you know, makes it better as far as like being able to fit a bunch of stuff. But I think mine, the reason I won't get anything else is because of the flowers, because as you can see, it's very dimensional, you know, once the flowers are here on there, so it's really hard for me to tuck things behind that. So anyway, that is my project share for today. I really hope you guys like it. And now to shove everything back in there. So thank you so much for watching. Let me know what you think, and I will be seeing you soon. I got a couple more things for my swap, and then I think I'm done. So thank you so much for watching. I'll see you real soon. Bye.